swat them out of the kitchen. Swat them out. This huge pestle, this is really big. And just, you know, thumb. Narrow, you flip. Circle, you don't flip. That you use for everything. Cut the chicken head, cut the papaya. Wow, thumb beach day. Sabaydi Pinong, hi fam, welcome back to Sang's Kitchen. Today we're talking about the essential Lao cooking equipment that you all need to get in order to build your kitchen and make it even extra Lao. So we're gonna talk about the different variations, where to buy it, how I use it. It's gonna be a lot of fun because we have galapao here. And also make sure you have a fly swatter because you know those darn hungry kids, they don't appreciate how long it takes to cook Lao food, so just swat them out of the kitchen. Swat them out. Okay, let's get talking. The first thing you need is a coconut sock, a Lao mortar and pestle. You see right here, I have different variations. I like to have different sizes just because if I'm making certain amounts, I want a bigger one or a smaller one. For example, if I'm making a small amount of dip. If you have like a big party and you're making thumb for like 20 people, of course I'm gonna use this size with this huge pestle. This is really big, and just, you know, thumb. But then if you're making a small amount of jiao dip of any sort, then go ahead and use a small one like this. And if you're a cute family of just like 2-3 people, then probably this size will work for you. And then if a little bit larger, this size. So I think variation is a spice of life. And what you're looking for at the grocery store is a mortar and pestle that is really high like this, and not one that's short and wide. Because a lot of times in Lao cooking, you're gonna be doing more of the smashing of like papaya salad and you don't want things to fling out. When it comes to the mortars, I recommend getting the clay kind. Don't get the wooden kind. I find that it's not as effective when it comes to pounding certain ingredients. And of course, the pestle is usually always made out of wood. So wooden pestle, clay mortar, okay? The next thing I recommend is getting your sticky rice equipment. So we know that sticky rice is one of the foundations of Lao food. So of course you're gonna have a lot of things that help you make sticky rice. So the first thing is called the huat kao, and it's pretty much this contraption, aluminum contraption on the bottom. And then there's this bamboo basket on top with a lid. And this is the small size. So you're gonna see two different variations. You get one that is more narrow on the bottom. And then the other one that looks like this, it's more circular. And it has more of a more surface area inside. So what I like to tell people is that if you're gonna be using this sticky rice cooker, then you actually don't need to flip. All you do is just do about 30 minutes, depending on how much rice you're cooking, and it's done. If you're using this sticky rice basket, then you wanna make sure that you flip halfway through the cooking process since it is so narrow that you wanna make sure all of the rice is cooked. So, narrow, you flip. Circle, you don't flip. Okay. And this is for when I have a gathering of 30 people way back in the past when all this crazy pandemic stuff wasn't happening. And then after your rice finishes cooking, you want to have some kind of platter that is heat resistant. I grew up using a platter that looks like this. I actually made this, so I bought it as a bamboo platter thing, just like this. Then using the back of a sticky rice bag, I cut it into a circle and flattened it out. And now every time I finish cooking my sticky rice, I put it right on here. And then you wanna aerate your sticky rice, get all that heat out before you put it into the sticky rice basket. Dip kao, dip kao. This is the sticky rice basket. I'm showing you all this one because this is the most recent one I got from my trip back in early 2020 of going to Laos. This is probably the prettiest one I have. You can see right in the back, I have a whole collection. Each one kind of brings back different memories, but you know, get the dip kao that is size friendly for your household. So if you have to feed like 5-6 people, then you want maybe double the size of this. If it's just yourself, you can probably have a small dip kao and you'll totally be fine. So definitely get everything that you need to make your sticky rice. And also note before I forget, these sticky rice cookers, they don't just steam sticky rice. You can steam anything in here. You can steam veggies, boil eggs right in here. Whatever you think of is using a steaming, go ahead and use this. It's very versatile, but know that this is at least essential when you're making traditional sticky rice. The next thing you want in your kitchen is a really good knife. I recommend a cleaver. I feel like every Asian household has a cleaver that you use for everything. Cut the chicken head, cut the papaya, cut your herbs, anything. Like, even to protect yourself, these cleavers come in handy. And then also, I thought just for fun, I don't do it too often, but if you want to make a really good curry, you need really fresh coconut milk. And the way to get fresh coconut milk is to make your own coconut milk. And so I have this, it's, you sit on it and then you have a coconut right on this sharp edge and you kind of grate the coconut and then you squeeze the milk out. And so this is what you use to get fresh coconut milk. Two pots that you need are for stews and then also just for steaming. So this, you can see, are so nostalgic. These are great for making a lot of Lao stews like gangnamai, ok, whatever stew you can think of, these will be perfect for it. And then also make sure you have your Asian steamer. You know, they have those nice holes right there. And so you can steam like your sticky rice parcels or your sukuyat sai, but these make great things to have on hand. Last but not least, you obviously need something to eat on. So growing up, my family always ate on a sot. So it's just like a rug for eating. And then also a pakao. So some type of small table that you put on top of the sot and everyone surrounds the table and enjoys Lao food. So for the sot, this is really nice because actually you can take this to the beach, take your thumb to the beach and have like a Lao thumb beach day. And also the same for this. Right now I eat on my table, but I think it's really nice to always have these two things just in case I ever want to sit on the floor right over there or go to the beach with these items. These definitely bring back a lot of childhood memories. I hope you enjoyed learning about the essential Lao cooking equipment that I have in my kitchen. Of course, there must be a lot more than this, so let me know in the comments below what other type of Lao cooking equipment that you have in your kitchen, and I'll see you all next time on Sang's Kitchen. Bye.
Bye.